Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and yesterday Apple released macOS Monterey 12.5 to the public. This is available to all macOS Monterey supported devices, so if you were able to install it before, you'll be able to install this update as well. And as you can see, this came in at 2.2 gigabytes. That's on an M1 MacBook Pro, and that's not a huge install, and it does have some updated features and changes. Now, along with this, Apple released iOS 15.6, iPadOS 15.6, WatchOS 8.7, tvOS 15.6, and HomePodOS 15.6. However, they also released macOS Big Sur 11.6.8, so if you're not using macOS Monterey, you'll be able to install the updates, at least for security, on macOS Big Sur. Now let's go ahead and close this. We'll take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll click on the Apple, click About This Mac, and as you can see, here's the version, click on the version, and this is build number 21G72. This just tells you which version you have and if it's the latest version or not. So this is what you should be on if you're already updated. Now, as far as new features in this update, well, there's a couple to mention. The first one is if we go into System Preferences, and then we go to our Desktop and Screensaver section. Under Desktop and Screensaver, if we scroll down a little bit, you'll see that we have some new wallpaper. These go along with the all-new MacBook Air wallpaper. So if we go into Safari, go to Apple, under Apple, if we go into the MacBook Air section here and click on Buy, you can see these wallpapers. So you'll see here's the wallpaper, and they correspond with the different colors, such as Midnight, Starlight, Space Gray, and Silver. So as you can see here, we have the different wallpaper available. Let me close Safari so you can see. And they're just built in now. So these came with the Mac, the MacBook M2, and now they're available for everyone. So those are available now. Now, aside from that, Apple also updated their TV app, specifically very similar to what they did with iOS. So if you're using TV, and if we scroll down here and you're watching live sports, you'll now have the option to either restart a live game, pause it, rewind it, or fast forward. And this is basically like having a built-in DVR. So we're going to have not just Major League Baseball, but soccer, as well as NFL, it looks like maybe later this year with the following season. It's hard to say if that's 100%, but it looks like something that could be coming soon. So if you're watching live sports on Apple TV, that could be incredibly helpful. Now, as far as new features, that's about it, but there are some bug fixes as well, and the first thing has to do with Safari. So if you're in Safari, and maybe you had a tab open, that tab could sometimes revert back to a previous page. So that's something that would happen from time to time, and that's actually been resolved. There's also no other known remaining features, according to Apple, in this particular update. So every time they update their notes, if we go to Apple's current release software update page, you can go to the release notes and you'll see there's nothing here. There are no new release notes for this software update. So they fixed all of the issues that were in the previous betas, and we should be good to go as far as that goes. However, there are a bunch of security updates in this update as well. And if we go to Apple's security website, you'll see here, if we scroll down, you can see all the current releases. So the security update for macOS Catalina and Big Sur as well. So we have both of those. I didn't mention the Catalina update, but macOS Monterey 12.5. And we have 50 different security updates. So there's quite a bit in this update as far as security is concerned. So they've patched a ton of different things, everything from AppleScript, audio, automation, and I believe this is more than double what we get with Apple WatchOS with security updates, and even iOS as well. So you'll see Intel graphics driver, the kernel's been updated, and as we continue down, you'll see SMB, software update, subversion, WebKit, and more. So Wi-Fi. And you'll see here, the way you read this is it says what it's available for, its impact is the problem it had, an app may be able to cause unexpected system termination or write kernel memory. In order to fix it, that's the description, this issue was addressed with improved checks. And then you have the person that submitted the issue. And so you can read each one of those like that. Even Windows Server has been updated as far as security updates. There's also additional recognition below of people that added assistance or helped Apple with assistance of some of these issues. So lots of updates, and that leads me to, should you install macOS 12.5? Well, if you're already on macOS Monterey, absolutely install it due to the security updates alone. If you're on a previous version, macOS Catalina, just make sure you get that security update installed that I showed you on the previous page here. So if you're on Catalina, you can see the same sort of security updates. The same is true if you're on macOS Big Sur. So just make sure you install the recent updates for either one of those versions if you're not going over to macOS Monterey. Now we're getting closer to macOS Ventura's release, which is expected sometime in usually around September. So September or October is typically what they do. So mid-September, maybe early October. And before then, we can also expect probably another update, whether that be macOS 12.6 or a 12.5.1. That's typically what Apple does. And then they release it either in August or September as we have a bunch of betas. So we could see a beta as soon as today, or it could be next week. But usually there'll be another set of betas with a final release, usually late August or September, with additional security updates and maybe some minor features. But most of those features should be released with macOS Ventura, where they added things such as continuity camera and much more. And so that's everything in this particular update. Not a ton, but a lot of important security updates. So again, I highly recommend installing it if you haven't already. If you found anything else I haven't mentioned, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link the iPhone version in the description below. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.